forecast certainly calls for a big drop in the temperatures, and the colder air raises a lot of health questions. So joining us with the answers is News Channel 5's medical specialist, Dr. David Soria. Welcome.
Thank
As
you.
Always, every Wednesday. When he's not here with us, he is the chief of emergency medicine at Wellington Regional Medical Center. So let's get right to the chilly questions.
All right.
Our first one, pretty common, but everybody, I think, wonders this. Does the cold weather in and of itself cause you to get sick?
Well, you know, for generations, we've been telling our kids that bundle up because you're going to get sick. In reality, it doesn't have anything to do directly with the transmission of a virus. Remember, colds and the flu are caused by a virus. So that is transmitted not by cold weather, but by nasal or oral secretions. Now, the indirect causes to how the cold weather can contribute is because a couple of things. One is, well, first of all, the flu season coincides with winter months, we tend to think that they're related when in reality they are not. The other thing is dry air actually helps the transmission of virus a little easier than humid or warm air. And lastly, the most important, and that is that, hey, when it's cold out, people are congregating inside, and so when they're together, it's easier to sneeze, spread the virus,
pass it around.
You got it.
All right. Really more of a coincidence than a cause.
Pretty much.
Probably.
That is correct. More
that makes
indirect.
Sense. That makes sense. Okay. Our next question for you today, even though it doesn't get that cold here in Florida, can you still get dry skin here?
You know, the humid weather absolutely helps, and it does so because it doesn't allow the moisture in the epidermal layer of the skin to be lost as quickly. And I remember, you know, I trained in Cleveland, Ohio, and I see a dramatic difference in the dryness of my skin, much more dry when I was up there. But there is a couple of ways where this humid weather and the humid warm weather will contribute to some of your dryness, and that is a couple things. One is the warm weather will help the losses of fluids from your body. And so that will lead to dehydration, which is one of the most common causes of dry skin. And the other two is exposure to sunlight that compromises the layer of the skin that helps retain the moisture. You lose more fluid and your skin becomes more dry. So make sure you use your moisturizers and sunscreens, and that'll help.
Makes sense. So yeah, we need it too.
You bet. No question.
All right, and our final question for you today, can the sun cause cold sores?
You know, a lot of people believe that, and in reality, it doesn't directly, but what it does is this. Well, first of all, cold sores are from the herpes simplex virus, the type 1. And what happens is it harbors in the nerves that surround your face and sometimes anywhere in your body, but particularly around the lips. And what happens is it remains dormant, and then it becomes active randomly, but certain things can precipitate it from coming back active. And one is the sunlight. Others is stress, colds, fevers, things like that. Anything that can suppress the immune system.
All right. Well, you've certainly cleared up a lot of myths for us today.
Good.
Thank you, as always. If you've got a question for Dr. Soria, you can always send it to us right on our website, WPTV.com. Just click the health link. You'll see it there on the right-hand side to fill out that form there and send him your question. So we thank you for coming in, as always, and we'll see you right after this short break. Stay with us.